One thing that many dogs and their owners alike dread is bath time. Whether you self-wash or you use a groomer, these are often stressful times for your dog. I myself am a big proponent of self-washing your dog. If your dog is bath adverse, this is a good time for you to build trust and a means of communication with your animal. Obviously, there are great groomers out there, but if you have the time and space, I say wash your dog yourself. It can be fun for both of you. The first thing you want to do is to tie bath time with something positive. In other words, offer treats, toys, and affection to get your dog to come to the bath. And every time your dog behaves in a way that's appropriate during bath time, reward them with a treat, a toy, or the affection. When bathing your dog, you want to be very careful not to get water in your dog's ears. Not only is it uncomfortable, it could also cause health problems. For the best results, start bathing your dog as young as possible. They'll be less opposed to the experience when they're younger because they won't have the negative associations toward it. One way to make a bath even more pleasant for your dog is to pick the right shampoo. The wrong shampoo is a shampoo that causes them to scratch or dries out their skin. You want to pick a shampoo that obviously leaves your dogs feeling refreshed and clean after a bath and not necessarily dried up and itchy. You want a mild soap that cleans and removes unwanted odors without stripping away essential oils. Talk with your vet to make sure that you're choosing the best shampoo for your breed and any special conditions that your dog may have. After a good rinse, be sure to dry your dog properly. Many people believe that a blow dryer is the most efficient tool for drying a dog. I totally disagree. I believe that a towel dryer is the best. No weird noise to scare your dog and no risk of skin burns from a hot dryer. If you guys have any tips, tricks, or stories, please leave them in the comment section below.